ladies and gents. I am doing a video today about my guide dog, Roxy. When you come home, it's very, very important to groom your dog every day. And I'll tell you why. It's kind of two-folded. One, for the bonding. I know while I was in my blind school, the first day we got our dog, because they were in the kennel, they were kind of gruffy and smelly. So they gave him a really nice bath. You know, we helped with it. And then after the bath and being tiled off, starting from that day, we had to brush them in the morning and the evening twice a day. And that was to help with the bonding process. Now, depending on what type of breed of dog you get as your guide dog, not a lot of dogs shed. My breed, Labradors, they shed a lot, so she enjoyed it. She would lay on the ground and just let me brush her, and I spent about 10 minutes brushing her on each session, and it really did help with the bonding, you know, having her trust me, having me the opportunity to get to know her personality and her knowing mine. So that time period of not working and not worrying about being in the harness and just relaxing and just talking, and talking in a soothing voice while giving her a good brushing, it really helped while I was in school with our bond. So it helps with the bonding. So depending on which blind school you go to get your blind dog, I mean your guide dog, not your blind dog, your guide dog, all schools are different, but I know the school I went to, it was not only to help with the shedding, but also to help develop that bond, because they come from a puppy raiser, then from the trainer, and then to you. So that kind of helps with the separation from the trainer to the new handler of the guide dog, which would be you, since you're in school. When you get home, what's so important, because when you're in school, you're kind of like in a bubble. So it's all about the bonding and just spending time and being relaxing and knowing how to use your soothing voice with your new guide dog and just getting to know each other. But when you get home, it's twofold. It's still a really great bonding experience. I don't do it twice a day now. I only do it once a day. I do it in the morning. In the next clip, I will show you how I groom Roxy, what tools I use. At school, the only tool you use is a brush. And again, depending on your breed, your breed may have an undercoat and a coat on top of it, so they can shed a lot. I know Labs shed a lot. German Shepherds, they shed a lot. But poodles, their type of hair doesn't have dander. They have more of a hair instead of a fur type of texture, so they don't shed. And I know some of my classmates, I had two classmates with poodles. They did not enjoy the brushing process at all because they don't shed. So the brushing process wasn't something that was relaxing to that breed while I was in school, from what I observed. But my lab and the German Shepherds, they love it because they shed everywhere. So I do brush Roxy once a day every morning. And I'll show you the tools and everything I use while I'm at home. But the important thing about grooming your dog when you get home as a guide dog is so important, because you're actually obviously using your guide dog to go into public places around other people. So with the ADA Act, and ADA stands for Americans with Disabilities Act. These are laws that protect people with disabilities. So when you go to a public property or public place with a guide dog that's been certified, that's very important, that has been certified, they have to let you in. And the only thing they can ask you is, one, are they a certified guide dog? And they can't ask you your condition or anything like that. So I always have my certified ID card with me and Roxy's picture on it wherever I go. But a public place has the right to tell you to leave if you do not follow these three things. Your pet must be under control and well obedient. You as a handler must have control. If you do not, they can ask you to leave, okay? Your dog has to be groomed and clean. If your dog is disgusting and smelly, Avi, they can ask you to leave. So that's why is the grooming process is so important, just for the bonding. And of course you wanna make sure your my rock star is looking just as good as their mommy. So I take pride and care when I groom her, and you'll see what kind of tools I use to make her coat really shiny. I always get compliments from people that see her, that one, that she's really well behaved and she just smells really good. and she doesn't smell like a dog. I don't even care about the dog smell because dogs are dogs. But the products I use, she has a very nice lavender camille scent. And I'll show you what I use to when I spray on her coat every day. But I always get compliments of how well behaved she is because she is so good. She's a rock star out in public, and how shiny her coat is. And you want to make sure that the sighted world, the public, has a positive experience when they come encountered with a guide dog. Another reason a public place can ask you to leave is if it's obviously posing a threat to others, like if it bites other people. That's more of an extreme situation because your guide dog should be obedient and not even get to that level. And if they are, you want to call the school that you got the dog to see how, if you need to come back for retraining or what tips they can give you to help with that scenario, because that should absolutely not be an issue, especially if you have a guide dog. So the next clip, I'll go ahead and show you how I grew my Roxy and what I use. I just use two products, and she loves it. And we spend this time in the morning, just her and I, just bonding and just enjoying the outdoors. 'Cause I brush her outside. If your dog sheds, doing it inside is a no-no because hair will get everywhere. And I do vacuum my house every single day, so that way I don't have hair everywhere. And I dust. I'm very OCD about cleanliness, so having a dog that sheds, I guess, is no big deal because I'm not allergic or anything, and I make sure I keep my house extremely clean, vacuumed and dusted, because my fiance has really bad allergies, and the first couple of days he had to get acclimated because he's on some allergy medicine. But since then, with his immunity being up, it doesn't bother him because I make sure I keep our house tip top and I keep Roxy tip top. So I hope you guys enjoy the next clip. And like I always say, guys, be you, stay true, and be naturally seen. And thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate your support when you're watching not only hair videos, but videos about my site and my guide dog and other videos that I may post. I really appreciate it. All right, guys, bye. I usually do this outside, but being in Ohio, we have freaky weather and it's like 35 degrees outside, snowing, windy, and cold. So this will be the only exception. I'll do it inside. But this is what I spray on her. I got this from my local pet store. It's from, I think it's PetSmart, Petland, one of those. Oh no, it's Pepco. And I'll go ahead and show you the ingredients, and I'll make sure I'll put it in the description box below as well. It's all natural. I know the main ingredients that make her smell good is the aloe vera juice, the chamomile, and lavender. So what I'll do, I have her sit, and with the Labrador, with their ears being so sensitive, and she is recouping from an ear infection, you don't want to ever wet their head. So the majority of the product, well, all the products will go on her body. And she's a medium-sized dog, so I'll make sure I spray a liberal amount. Then I take my brush. It's just a regular brush I got from my blind school. And any shedded hair, I make sure I clean out every day. And I first brush down. And sometimes your dog, if they have sensitive skin, they may have some dandruff. She has some dandruff when she got home, but I think I got control of it now, as you can see. Just daily grooming and moisturization, like our hair, helps them. And she's changing size because it's comfortable for her. After you comb down, you do, because of her shedding, you do have to comb up to get the undercoat like this. And when I'm done, then I comb down just to comb it down. And as you see, there's some shedded hair right there, but because I comb her every day, she doesn't shed as much. But if you skip it will be a hairy nightmare. So guys, that's how I groom Roxy. Thanks so much. See you guys in the next one. Bye.